heart full of thanksgiving for the God. Lord, may you forgive us, Father, for all our sins, Father God. Anything we may have done, Father God, Lord, we just want to repent and say we're sorry, Lord.
Yes.
Father God, if we have been led a certain way, Father God, we thank you for putting us on the right path, Father God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father God.
Yes.
Right now, Lord, we just lift up every person, every man, woman, boy, girl, children this morning, Father God. Every lost soul, Father God. Every person that's lost and guarded. Every person that has been deceived, Father God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we just lift them up to you, Father God. And ask, Father God, that you just ask every person, every man, boy, girl, just for encountering you, Father God, in a supernatural way, Father God. We know that when your anointing is encountered by mankind, Father God, they will never be the same again, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord. Lord, we lift up Pastor Joseph and Bridget Stein to you,
Father God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Thank you, Father God, for covering them, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
In the mighty name of Jesus, we lift up every auxiliary this morning, Father God. We lift up every person this morning to you, Father God. And we just thank you for watching over us and taking care of us, Father God.
Thank you
for the lead guide us, Father God. In Jesus' name. We give y'all a praise doing love in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Hallelujah. 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 Good morning. Good morning. That's how you're born.
Good Lord.
That's the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This morning, Father God, we're going to be talking about the promises of God. God fulfilling his promises. So no matter what's going on in your life, God is going to come through no matter what. Well, I just want to pray for the married folk this morning. Y'all know I'm a big advocate of marriage. I just want to pray for the men in the room this morning, Father God, just continue keeping them united on one accord. I see so many men and women, you know what I'm saying, don't really pray for their spouses like they're supposed to.
No, no.
You know what I'm saying?
They're supposed to give it up.
Every other person, but they're going to live up their own spouse. That's a
truth. No, no. That's
a truth. You should be praying for the person that you live next to. And for the person who God put in your life. You should be praying for that person. You should be praying for that person. You know what I'm saying? I think it's kind of crazy if you want to go pray for your mom or your sister. You want to pray for your kid. You can see the good in everybody else, but you can't see the evil in your spouse. But you don't know what they did. But I see what your parent did, what your kid did. Your kid living like crazy, but you want to point to your husband like you're pointing your wife like she. Come on now.
Come on.
The devil is a lie.
Oh, yeah.
The devil is a lie. We all have our roles we're supposed to play in the marriage. You know what I'm saying? For real though, the man's going to play the role of a man, the woman's going to play the role of a woman. And you don't see no man saying, Lord, give me the spirit of Sarah. Give me the spirit of Elizabeth. That's not his job to be a Sarah. That's not his job to be your Elizabeth.
Right.
It's not your job to be his David. You're supposed to be, you know what I'm saying, in the spirit, yeah, but it's not your job to be trying to act like David in your household. You're not his David. He's not your Sarah. That's the big stuff. Y'all never hear a man say he wants the spirit of a woman to come up on him. You don't ever see him on a feminine spirit. You know what I'm saying? The same woman, you should want to be have a masculine spirit with your husband. It go both ways. You know what I'm saying? The Bible tells each one of us how to act and how to roll in marriage. Amen.
Amen.
When we try to act different according to how we want to act, and then that's when the enemy come in and have his way. I'm telling you, that's when he come in and have his way. You should keep each other lifted up no matter what. Sometimes, you know what I'm saying, he need to point the thing at you. You know, something going on, let me see what I'm doing. Let me see how I'm going to act as a man or woman and girl. Let me see if I'm not loving enough.
That's right.
Let me see if I'm not forgiving enough.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you got to look and check your own self.
That's right.
Because it might be you. You're supposed to be a leading person in the household, so sometimes you got to, am I leading correctly?
That's right.
Am I reacting correctly?
That's right.
Because it's not always the person. Sometimes you got to point the finger. Oh,
that's right. I'm going to get right now.
You're the man, bro. You need to do things a little different. You need to act a little different. It ain't always easy, is it? It's not always easy. If you married, you correct thing always. It ain't easy for you to correct how you feel, but correct what you say. I mean, for the act of how you feel, what you say, sometimes you might react out in the wrong way. But you need to check and correct yourself. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Don't let no enemy come in between your marriage. That's his job. God is married to us.
That's right.
We should look at that as our example. God is married to us. Look at that one. The devil wanted to come in between us and God.
That's right.
He wanna put something, he wanna make you do something for so that way, you know what I'm saying, you can be away from God, so you can be separated from God.
Separate
all
God.
Our lives.
Separate.
Separate us from God. But as long as we got Jesus, as long as we put him first in our life, and then there's nothing that the enemy can do. Y'all understand? There's nothing he can do. That's what Jesus came for, to bring us back to the Father. For to bring us back is what? We've been separated from, you know what I'm saying? God said, no, I want y'all separated from me. I made y'all wonderfully and fearfully. Look at how you think. You think amazing. Look at how you move. You move amazing. You don't even know how I put your body together. I stretch your body in a way that doctors can't even figure it out. Doctors can't figure out where these miracles coming from, how I'm getting, how I'm blessed.
Okay.
I reconstructed you in a way that, you know what I'm saying, only me, myself, know how to reconstruct you and construct you, how to put you together, take you apart, and put you back together.
Right.
He said, I constructed you in that way.
Right.
Not no man. So we don't need to stop giving man any type of glory, because why?
God get all the glory.
God get all the glory.
Get all the glory. Get all the praise.
Amen. And I want to talk to y'all about, you know what I'm saying, just relationship. Be careful who you're in a relationship with, even before you get married, going into marriage. Stop getting a relationship before you get married. I don't even know who this part, I'm telling this for somebody. Stop getting relationships and trying to do married things. Stop getting a relationship before you get married and trying to do married things.
Thank Lord.
Right. You need to be with, in fact, that they used to coach somebody. Let me get to know you. Let me spend time with you. Go to their house and spend time with them while their parents there. You know what I'm saying? When you was younger. You know what I'm saying? When you get older, you know what I'm saying? You still need to do things in a respectful way. For real, though, because you go off and you do things different, then you blame them. You go off and then a man have a baby with a woman, he blaming this woman. But what about you? Man, she acting a fool. She want to take me to court.
Yep.
She want to put me on paper and say, bro, you got they got some kind of consequences for your sin, my brother. You know what I'm saying? You can't get mad up and not do something the consequences for your sin. She going crazy. She busting up with him, bro. They call consequences.
Come on.
Maybe y'all have these men, baby. Well, guess what? I mean, he ain't there. Well, baby, you suffer the consequences of your sins. You trying to beat him up and talk about him like, hey, what about what you did, though?
That's right.
You got to start looking at yourself for, well, hold up, why I'm going through this? But man, you made some bad decisions. That's right. It could be a man or woman. You made bad decisions. Accept your decision. Once you start accepting the consequence that you did, it'll start shaping up a whole lot better for you. Once you start, then your prayers will get different then. God, I know I was wrong, and I did this wrong, God. I need you for the baby this
right.
For real, though, you start changing up your prayers. You know what I'm saying? God, I need you for the change they want. I need you for the baby and the parent they need to be. You know what I'm saying? See, then all that bitterness come out you that you might have toward that person.
Yeah.
But you don't know what they did me.
All right.
I know what you did yourself. I know what you got yourself into.
Yes,
I'm just saying, before you get in this relationship, you better be careful for real, though. Because me, I don't want to hear nothing about my baby mama, my baby daddy. Nah, why you got a baby mama, baby daddy?
Yeah.
I'm guilty of it myself, so you know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to down talk nobody. For real, before I got married, I ain't know no better. I was out here the same way. You know what I'm saying? Got somebody that was pregnant or whatever, and you not, and got blues going to court every other month. You know, I'm mad at her. Nah, it don't work like that, brother. What about you? What you did? First of all, you shouldn't have been out there doing what you were doing.
That's right.
And then you want to put your mouth on it, like, how about you pray for this lady?
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? There were times you were looking at the stuff that this lady was going through, what she was getting. Now you got to deal with experience. Come on now. Now you got to change up your prayer. Now you got to start looking at yourself. Man, I was wrong. You can't say they was wrong. I was wrong for what I did. I was wrong for, you know what I'm saying, coming up incorrectly, not looking at, you know, we was all out in the world one time.
Man,
you ain't by yourself, you done messed up. But God here for
gonna protect you through our land.
That's right. Brother Gary now.
God, he's gonna protect you. Yeah, you're gonna use, you're gonna suffer the consequences of the choices that you made. But when God leads you through these consequences,
that's
it's
right.
Okay.
He
gonna carry you. He gonna forgive you. He gonna love you. He gonna make sure everything come out straight. And what the devil meant for evil, God did it for good. God did it for good. Stop looking at everything so evil. God meant the evil for good. So, but it's up to you for the making choice. You can't continue for the just turn and waddle in all that sin and evil. You gotta make up a choice in your mind to say, man, I'm going to stop this day. I'm not going to continue to let the enemy use me for the God in this way. For mess with any and everybody because I got an itch or a feeling.
Come on here.
Come on, because guess what? You're going to have to suffer low consequences. And that's what the enemy wants. The enemy wants to keep your mind wrapped up in bull crap.
Amen.
The enemy wants to keep your mind all, make the kids hate the mother. Make the kids hate the father. That's a trap of the enemy.
Right.
That's a trick of the enemy.
Yeah.
That's the, your dad ain't this, your mom ain't that. No, you don't got to teach them nothing. Guess what? You don't know what God knows with that person.
Right.
God might get that person mind so right, might get their mind so right that you know what I'm saying, might be the best parent that ever could be.
Right.
But I've been there, I've been there through this and that. Okay, well, you made that choice, and you know what I'm saying? You went through no consequences.
Lord,
that's
right. Lord.
For real, though, you knew better, though.
Jesus.
He probably didn't know better, but you did. You knew God. You knew God more than he did.
Oh my
you
God.
You knew God more than he did.
Yes.
You knew that your mom and dad have been praying for you, been telling you about God.
Yes, Lord.
I'm going to talk about the promises of God because God going to come and everything God tell you, God going to do. Everything God tell you, he going to do. There's not one thing that God tells you that he's not going to do. There's not one promise that God made that he's not going to fulfill in your life. Not one. It don't matter if it happened today or tomorrow. It might not happen on your time, but
it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. Just like God said,
God's time is different from your time.
You might
be going through all kinds of stuff. You're like, God, I need you to come through right now and make this happen. And God be like, no, I need you to go through the next moment because I know you ain't heard your lesson yet. I know if I come too early, if I ain't done, you're gonna try me again. You're gonna forget to hit them knees and get in my face every day like you've been bending my face for these past months. I've been loving this relationship with you, God say. He said, but if I come to move too early on your behalf because you want me to right now, well, you're gonna think it's all good. I'm gonna move too early on your behalf, and you're gonna try again. You're gonna go back and do the same thing again. He say, so you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna let you suffer, nigga.
Oh my God.
You know, ain't that wrong with suffer? God suffered. Jesus said, God say, even if you suffer for the good, he say, blessed be it you.
Amen.
So ain't that wrong with it is suffering? Especially when you suffer for something that you need. You gotta take it away. If you did anything that was
wrong, you got
consequences.
That's right. Consequences.
That's right.
God is a fair for God. I said, the person that I don't chastise, I must don't love you. Must be a man of the child.
Yeah, come on, man.
The Bible said, count it all joy when you're going through things.
God, you're trying to save you.
You ain't going through this here because God don't love you.
Come on,
no, you're going through because he loves you. If you ain't going through it, you're going to continue for them to do the same thing.
Come on, God
said, no, I'm going to fill this out once and for all. And the devil will not get no glory out of
you. Be no glory out of Brother Gary.
God wants you.
No.
God wants you. It's all about you.
Brother Gary,
it's all about us. It's been all about us since day one. It's all about us. God love us.
Yes, Lord.
God said, no matter what you do, I'm going to do this thing for my name's sake. It don't matter how much the people of the Israelites act up. God never turned his back on him and
said, "Give him."
Give
him. Give him. What? I'm doing this for my name's sake.
My name's sake. Come on, B.
When all these people was beating and abusing Jesus, and Jesus still had to go through.
Come on, Pastor B.
Who Jesus did that for? He didn't do that for himself. He did that for us.
Come on, Pastor B.
His death was for us. The beating and abuse, all the whippings, that was for us. The lying, the backbiting, that was for us.
Yeah.
Brother Gary, so now. Brother Gary, so now. Do
anything, somebody
lying to
me. Brother Gary,
now.
Brother
Gary, now. Just anything.
Brother
Gary,
now.
It's okay. It's all good.
Yes.
God got you.
Brother
Gary, God got you.
Brother Gary, now.
It's for his glory.
Yeah, Lord. Come on, Pastor Gary.
It's for his glory. God said he's going to do everything he's saying.
Come on, Pastor
Gary. In the book of Noah. What God told Noah, God said, man, I'm tired of these people acting up.
Woo!
He said, all of them doing wrong. I'm going to cause the flood, build a ship.
Come on, get now.
All Noah did what God said. He ain't know how he was going to do, because at the time, he didn't say it was going to rain. He just said it was going to flood.
Come on, B.
I don't know if y'all know, but we serve a God bigger than we know, and we serve. Some people say, God of the universe. Man, God way more bigger than God. My God is way before
eternity.
Yeah, my mama said, God, he finished. He bigger than God, he
finished.
This man is so big. This man is bypassing anything we can think of. He gave us words to try to relate, but even the words he give us can relate to the God we serve.
Hallelujah.
Everything he did for us, y'all. Jesus Christ came on this earth, came on earth, and he threw that for God for us. He gave us the Holy Spirit dwelling inside of us. Did he need the Holy Spirit for himself?
No.
But everything he did for us.
Everything
he did for us. God don't need nothing to nobody.
Oh, my God.
God don't need nothing to nobody.
He did for us.
Everything God did was for us.
Yes.
For where the sun, the moon, and the stars, that was for us. Everything placed in perfect accord. The sun of where it's supposed to be for a reason. The sun right where it's at and far enough away from us that we don't fry and burn up.
Come on.
Everything is done perfectly. Yeah. You look around it in your life, you look around in nature, everything is done perfectly.
Come on, Pete.
God told Noah it was going to flood.
Mm-hmm.
It was a promise God made. It's going to flood. He didn't tell my God about what to tell you how he's going to do things. For real, it might be looking like, man, this is impossible. I ain't never seen this happen before. What is he talking about? What is God telling me? Man, all you got to do is just stand firm and believe in God, because God stay want to show you new things. God show us, God stay want to show up and show out. God stay want to do things for his glory.
Yes, Lord.
Chapter 7, what did God say? Man, I'm going to be in 7 days hard, make it rain.
Come on,
man.
Come on,
Pastor
B.
We preached about it. He told
me. Come on,
yeah. He came and told me, it's going to rain. Rain. They never seen rain.
Right.
But my Bible said it hadn't even rained.
That's right, baby.
Water comes from the ground.
That's right, baby.
According to my Bible.
That's
so
right.
So we're about to rain. A new thing is about to rain. God said to destroy everything with you and your family. Everything God said, what happened? It came to me.
Yeah.
It manifested itself.
It's
going to
happen.
Just so you don't know that
I need to.
I did this for you.
Come on, yeah.
I love you.
Yeah.
I'm your father.
Yeah.
I'm always looking out for your best interest.
Yeah, yes.
God, I always looking out for your best interest. It don't matter what you're going through, God looking out for your best interest. It ain't happening here because you're not going for you.
Come on.
You pray for God and remain in the state with God. Say, I'm going to make sure you get this one.
Come on, Pastor B.
He said, because you know, I'll give you something, and then you'll give it over to the dogs.
That's right.
You'll let other people and things trample over something I give
that's
you because
right.
You
bring that people right.
Brother Gabriel.
No,
have mercy.
You can do that thing with small, but when I finish it, you know what I'm saying? You're going to appreciate this thing.
That's right.
I'm so
you're going to appreciate it.
I'm so
that's why we're going through these things. God said, and don't think you the only person going through something.
That's right, that's right.
They call the Spirit of God.
Why are you the only? Why are me?
Right, that's right.
Why are me? When you open your lip.
Lord.
You open your ears and listen to the person on your lip.
That's right.
Open your ears and listen to the person on your right.
That's right.
Going through something. They got somebody they deal with in their family. They got
that's
a
right.
Mother
that's
they
right.
Do. They got an auntie or mama or daddy. They got something
that's right.
They got
something
that they're
right.
Brother
Gary,
now.
It ain't
just
me.
Somebody you saying prayers for yourself. You need to be praying for others too.
That's right. I do.
That's what we put here for to do, for to uplift each other, for the
family.
Yeah.
Man.
Right.
God love nothing more for us to give him all the praise and glory.
That's
what you're here for.
That's
what you're here for. And watch God do the work. Watch God heal.
Come on, baby.
Watch God deliver. Watch God set free.
Come on here.
God want to use you. God just want to hear
something.
Take some time out and talk to God.
Come on now.
It rained. It flooded everything.
Two by two.
Come on.
Everything flooded. Except where God wanted to live. Hallelujah. Except where he wanted to live. So don't worry about things dying around you.
Come on, Jesus.
Don't worry about things dying around you.
Let
it down.
Let
it
down. Come on, Pete.
God said, I got the plan for you. He said, I saved you for a purpose.
That's right.
It could have been you.
That's right.
But you got a purpose. You got a purpose here.
Yes.
He said, now it's your turn for the show up.
Yes.
He said, you going to come here? You going to listen to me?
Come on, Jesus.
He told Abraham, he said, Abraham, look, I'm going to give you the city that can outnumber the stars in the sky.
That's right.
He told me, you're going to be as big as the dust and the sand on the sea. You're going to be able to count. Abraham ain't have no kids. Abraham was in his 80s.
That's right.
He was in his 80s. Then what happened?
He had his fear, though.
And God was like, Come on, baby.
That's the promised child.
He's not the promised child.
Come on, now, Come on, Pastor B.
Then what happened about 12, 13 years later? God made a promise. God said, the promise child
won't
come from
one another. See, the way they did things, God was
going to
do it.
That's how God did. That's how we going to have a child at this old age. God said, this is the way I want to do it.
If I'd have been through his brother, you would get to do it.
You think you figured me out? I don't think we can figure out.
Come on,
that's me. Yeah, this Bible, all that God is in this Bible, right? But all this Bible is not God. God is more than this Bible.
Oh, he sure is.
But this Bible is all of God.
Right.
But you can't put all of God in this Bible. You cannot put all of God in his Bible. You cannot, man, God is so big there. It's impossible. I don't care if you write a million books. You cannot do that. God is too huge. He's just too large. See, these words don't say it can't even describe.
Almighty. I don't know.
I'm just saying, I'm a majestic God. Now, you can't figure this man out.
No.
God said, I'm going to do it another way. Not the way you think I'm going to do it. Not the way you want me to do it. You don't have the time to do it. You don't have the time to pay it. right? And then what ended up happening? She ended up getting pregnant. She had to laugh herself. Lord, I can't believe
that. Open that womb up.
Lord, I cannot believe that you did it this away, Lord.
Come on now, you and God go get the last laugh.
She couldn't do nothing to get God. Wow. She didn't know her neighbor had no power to do. She only had to be God.
God had to do that.
It had to be God.
That's right.
It had to be God.
Come on now.
That one child she had, that's where the promise came from, that one child.
Come on. Wow.
And then what he did, he went and put on Abraham to sleep, right? He told Abraham, he said, you're going to have descendants in Egypt, and they're going to come out 400 years later. Mm. He said, but when they come out, though, he said, I'm going to punish the nation
that
enslaved them,
that
oppressed them. And then what he told him, he said, when they come out, they won't be broke. They're going to be good. He told him, 100 years early. They got articles of silver. They got articles of gold. And they got clothing. They plundered and they came out with it. They was oppressed for these people for all them years. Like the Bible say, 400 years.
Yeah, Lord.
And then what happened? They came out with it. They came out on top.
On what money?
And then God had to wheel them out of shit. It's like he almost had to kick them out, push them out. Man, get them out of here, y'all. Every time they want to turn back, y'all, we going back. Get on down, for real.
Come on now, man.
God, like, I'm trying to give you something new. I'm trying to bring you to a new level.
Woo!
I'm trying to bring you to a new space.
Come on, B.
I'm trying to bring you to a new land.
Come on, B.
He said, all you got to do is follow me. But what they kept doing? What they kept doing, y'all? They kept turning their back on God. They kept walking in unbelief. Every time, God, they done seen all the miracles. That we done seen everything God been doing for us and have done for us. We done seen it. And no time, there is not no time that we should have doubting God.
That's right. No doubt.
All
time will be. No doubt. All
time
will
be. No time we should doubt God.
Come on back to me.
That's disheartening to God. That's so disheartening to God for him to be your father, and then you don't respect that he tell you he going to do something for you and you don't want to believe or trust him. That is disheartening. That's disheartening to anybody.
That's grateful.
That's disheartening to us parents on earth when we be like that. We tell our kids something they don't believe but they don't trust it.
That's disheartening. Hallelujah. And then we're going to skip over to Moses. Exodus chapter 3.
wheelchair.
Not point.
Not point.
Come on, Pastor Pete.
Lord Jesus.
Come on, Pastor Pete. You got an armor behind you, boy. Come on.
Yes, Lord.
You already got
on
behind.
Man, true. Story there, verse chapter
3. Uh-huh.
This is what Moses said when talking to the burning fire. God appeared to Moses in the burning bush.
Uh-huh.
And Moses was curious. He was like, man, this bush on fire, but it ain't burning up. And he gonna talk to him. God showing up in an amazing way.
Yeah.
So God started talking to Moses, right? And let him know what he got praying for Moses. And then he goes on. After he telling him that he gonna go back to all Egypt and he gonna rescue his people. We gonna start in verse 19. He says, I am sure that the king of Egypt will not let you go. Not by mighty hand.
Come on, baby.
I will stretch out my hand and smite Egypt with all my wonders, which I will do in the midst thereof, and after that he will let you go. And I will give this people favor in the sight of the Egyptians.
That's right.
God said, I'm going to give you favor in the sight of your enemies.
Favor.
And it shall come to pass when you go, you shall not go out empty-handed. It says, verse 22, and that every woman shall bore of her neighbor.
Whoa! Come on, Pastor.
And I put that sojourner in her house, Jews of silver, Jews of gold, and raiment. And you shall put them on your sons and upon your daughters, and you shall spoil the Egyptians.
Lord Jesus, come on, Pastor B.
That's what he's saying. That's the promise he made. You know the Exodus chapter 12.
Come on,
have
your faith, baby.
And we're going to start at 31, 12 and 31. It says, Pharaoh sent for Moses and Aaron during the night.
Uh-huh.
Get out, he ordered them.
Come on, yeah.
Hold up. That's right. So look, even before that, all right, so this is what happened. Go ahead and made a promise to him and never keep it to him. All right, Exodus chapter 4. Just back up a little bit, and we're going to go back to Exodus 12.
Okay.
Exodus 4. So we're going to see. In chapter 12, two or three things being fulfilled in God's
okay.
So we're going to go in for
Exodus
4.
Okay.
We're going to start at 18.
Okay.
So Moses went back home to Jethro, his father-in-law.
Uh-huh.
Please let me return to my relatives in Egypt, Moses said.
Come on,
I don't even know if they are still alive. Go to peace, his father-in-law said. Before Moses left Midian, the Lord said to him, return to Egypt, for all those who wanted to kill you have died.
Right.
So Moses took his wife and sons, put them on a donkey and headed back to the land of Egypt. In his hand he carried the staff of God. And the Lord told Moses, when you arrive in Egypt, go to Pharaoh and perform all these miracles I have empowered
to
do.
That's what you got.
But I will harden his heart so he will refuse to let the people go.
Right.
Then you will tell him this is what the Lord says.
Right.
Israel is my firstborn son.
Right.
I command you, let my son go
right. So
he can worship me.
Right.
But since you have refused, I will now kill your firstborn son.
Right.
So God already promised telling him to tell Pharaoh, if you don't let my children go,
I'm
going to kill your firstborn. Firstborn of everything.
Yes,
God made his promise and told this to his enemy.
Yes.
God promised your enemy, I'm going to defeat you.
Okay.
God has defeated your enemy already.
Yes. Yes.
God has already defeated your enemy.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So we're going to go to Exodus 12. All right, so we're going to start at Exodus 12 and 28.
Okay.
So what had happened, you know what I'm saying? This was the time when God told him, Gabriel came. God says, this is what you're going to do. You're going to kill a man.
Uh-huh.
And he said, you're going to take the blood of the man.
Put all over
and
the
you're going to put it around your doorpost and on the side. Hallelujah.
Yes.
The blood of the lamb.
Yes, God.
The blood
yes,
of the
Lord. Yeah.
And the blood of Jesus Christ on your
hands. Sure.
Hallelujah.
Come on. I love come on.
No.
Everybody has the pass over you. God said, I gave you the blood for this.
That's right.
He says, so the people of Israel did just as the Lord commanded him through Moses and Aaron. That night at midnight, the Lord struck down all the firstborn sons in the land of Egypt. From the firstborn of Pharaoh, who sat on his throne, to the firstborn son of the prisoner in the dungeon, even the firstborn of their livestock was killed. Promise fulfilled. Lord told them, if you don't let my people go, I'm going to take out your firstborn.
That's right.
That's Christ. Come on.
We're going to keep going.
Uh-huh.
It says, Pharaoh and all his officials and all the people of Egypt woke up during the night, and a loud wailing was heard throughout the land of Egypt. There was not a single house where someone had not died. It says, Pharaoh sent for Moses and Aaron during the night. Get out of your order. Leave my people, boy. Boy, you tell me something. They ain't even gonna be trying to come blessings at you. Just take me back. Just take me back.
No.
Worship the Lord as you have requested.
Come on,
you see how God answered your request?
Yes!
What you requested from God? God is going to make it happen.
That's right.
God is going to make it happen. On their shoulders. And the people of Israel did as Moses had instructed. They asked the Egyptians for clothing and articles of silver and gold. Come on here, y'all. God told him way back in Abraham time what was going to happen.
That's right.
God said, you're going to go out blessed. You're going to go out with them. And then God said, I'm going to punish them.
That's right.
It said,
Hallelujah.
The Lord called the Egyptians to look favorably on the Israelites, and they gave the Israelites whatever they asked for. God, long as you're in the will of God, God will give you what you ask for. So they stripped the Egyptians of their will. You might think that the person that's doing all the wrong and they getting away with it, they not getting
away with it.
David said, when I went in the sanctuary of the Lord, then I could see, Father, they was on the slippery slope.
Oh,
don't be jealous of what the enemy doing.
Right.
They on the slippery slope. Before you look up, you know what I'm saying? They were not going to be found. He said, that night the people of Israel left Ramses, started for Succoth. There were about 600,000 men, plus all the women and children. He said they also had non-Israelites with them. They had people that weren't even part of being Israelite wanted to go with them. We going with y'all too. We going to serve God. Come on,
come on.
We find the same Lord Jesus. Y'all just got to stick strong with God. Stick
man.
children. Watch what God about to do.
Watch.
You need to sit back and watch what God about to do.
He's going to do it.
For the bread that was, he said, for bread that baked flat cakes from the dough without yeast they had brought from Egypt. It was made without yeast because the people were driven out of Egypt in such a hurry that they had no time to prepare the food. The people of Israel had lived in Egypt for 430 years. That's exactly what God told them.
Okay.
The promise don't come through. It might not come on your time.
It's going to happen.
It's going to happen.
Whatever
God telling you, whatever he told you,
it's going to happen.
He's praying for you. Don't get weary in the way of doing it. I'm doing it. what?
Yes, amen.
Yes, amen.
As long as you follow the will of God, it's okay.
Yes.
Don't worry about the little things that happen in your life. It's okay. It'll be all right. I'm not going to be the trick of the enemy to deceive what you've seen.
What you've seen.
Every time the Israelites were tricked by what they were seeing. Right. They was by the end of the promised land. They were tricked by the giants. Oh, we seen giants. We're not going to be able to defeat them.
That's
it's
right.
The trick of the enemy.
Right.
He used yourself for the trick yourself. Well, Nick, I'm going to trick you about what you heard. You seen this?
Come on.
I'm
going to
trick you about what you seen.
What
happened? The Israelites seen that before they crossed the Red Sea, what they did. They seen the Egyptians about to come up on them, and what
that's
they
right.
seen. Oh, we about to die.
Yeah.
Moses, why are you about us out here going to die?
They
were tricked by what they seen.
Go through.
Moses said, just chill.
And go through.
Part of the Red Sea.
Come on, yeah.
God going to do something for you amazing in life, supernatural in life. Stop looking for the same old way. Stop looking for the same old way. Stop looking for respond on your time, on your watch, on your clock.
Yes!
That's
the man. Hallelujah!
That's the one for the baby. Whatever it is you ask the God for,
it's going to happen.
If you would like to stand in a place for anybody that you love, any person, we here for the standard of being a good shepherd.
Come on, Jesus.
We are here for one another. That's what God put us here for. We're here for one another.
Yes,
if there's anybody here that would like to become part of the family, other ministry of the come on up. If there's anybody that would like to become a part of the family of the body of Christ, amen.
Come on, get ready.
Come on up.
Right.
God is waiting on you. Wide, arms wide open. Wide open. Full of love.
Yes.
Faithful. Is there anyone here that would like to receive the indwelling of the Holy Spirit? Please come on up. There better not be anyone that's not heard until the call. Then I'm going to drop off in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God bless you, Pastor King.
Lord God, for I speak, Lord God, You told me to speak your word on whatever situation is going on. And you're going to watch over your word to perform it. But it will not come back void. It's coming back with a good report. We're going to thank you right now for the good report that is coming back. The power is going to come back with a good report of what you did. I pray that you answer our prayer. Because you told me, Lord God, you have answered our prayer.
Yes, Lord.
I believe you, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
And I know one thing. It's gonna happen.
It's gonna happen,
Lord God. We got your word on it, Lord God. This morning, Lord God. Who am I hiding yet something like this? But I tell that the feet are too legged down. You back the hell up in the name of Jesus.
Come on, baby.
I don't mean back the hell halfway. Back the hell all the way up off this woman of God.
Come on, Jesus.
She stands for so many, Lord God.
Yes, she does.
She trusts you. She come from a low position. But Lord, she don't mind coming, Lord God. And I ask you, Lord God, continue, Lord God, to crown her with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. I order the shadows of your way, and no devil in hell will be able to find her, Lord God. Because she's covered from the mold of her head to the sole of her feet with your blood, Lord God. In the name of Jesus. Now, Lord God, we trust in your word. We're standing on your word, Lord God. We thank you for everything you've done, doing, and that you still will do for everything that we have right now, Lord. It's because of you, Lord God, that you used me to speak this word. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. It's already done. We give you honor, glory, and praise, Lord God. Every day of our lives, Lord God.
Come on, Jesus.
Truly, Lord, your word.
Yeah, Lord.
Your word. And we're standing on your word.
Yes, Lord.
Before I take my seat, it's going to happen.
It's
going
to
happen. It's going to
happen.
It's going to happen. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Thank you, Lord.
Lord, that was awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.